Being a ministry wife is a vocation without a job description. And let's be honest, sometimes it seems like ministry might be easier if we did have one. If you are a ministry wife like me and are looking for hope, perspective, and a little bit of practical advice regarding your role, you're in the right place. Hi, I'm Christine Hoover. Welcome to the Ministry Wives Podcast, a production of the North American Mission Board. Join me as we hear from women from various ministry contexts, having authentic conversations about our shared joys and challenges, even the ones we're unsure we can talk about. No topic is off limits. Today, I have two guests joining me on the podcast, Meredith Miller and Bailey Leitch. Meredith and Bailey serve together at Center Church in Charlottesville, Virginia. Meredith is married to Josh, who is the lead pastor of Center Church, and together they have four kids. Bailey is married to Justin, who is the executive pastor at Center Church, and they have two kids. Meredith and Bailey join me today to talk about our relationships with other pastors' wives, specifically the ones at our own church. Here, friends, is my conversation with Meredith and Bailey. I am super excited to welcome my friends, Bailey Leitch and Meredith Miller, to the podcast. Welcome, you guys.
Hi.
So fun to get to talk to y'all together. It's fun. I think it's kind of fun when there's more than two people. Like the conversation that can happen is really fun. So will y'all start? I'll just ask Meredith, will you start by telling us about your church context? Because y'all are serving in the same church.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we are. Yep. So yes, I'm Meredith, married to Josh. Josh is the lead pastor of Center Church is the name of our church. We planted it with Justin and Bailey about a little over 4 years ago. So that is really fun. And we just moved into our first permanent home, our church, which is amazing.
Amazing.
And has been everything we hoped it would be. The Lord is using it. Like, just such an incredible time for our church. And yeah, Josh and I have four kids. We have 8, 7, 5, and 18 months. So we're very busy and very tired.
Yes. Okay, Bailey, tell us about your family.
Yeah, I'm married to Justin and we have two kids. We have a 2-year-old and we have a 4-month-old, and likewise, a little busy over here.
Yeah.
And Justin is the executive pastor of Center Church.
That's awesome. Well, I know you guys in real life because we were serving at Charlottesville when you came to plant. So y'all planted out of Summit in North Carolina. And I think this is so fascinating. Two things about it. One is y'all joined up with us for a while. You just came to our church for probably like 9 months to a year.
Yeah,
is that right?
Yeah.
And just along. Which was incredible for us because y'all brought some fresh energy and it was just fun to have y'all get to know people who were moving to Charlottesville to plant this new church. So once y'all did plant, we could tell people, you know, if we're not the right fit, hey, there's another church. We know these people, they're awesome, doing good work. But the second thing I found fascinating is that y'all's team planted and most of you didn't know each other before you came. Mm-hmm. Tell us about that. Like, how did that work?
Yeah, it is really interesting. Even people to this day, I think, who are members of Center Church now, they look at the launch team is what we called it. And they just assume that we were all friends connected, but Summit is so big. There's multiple campuses that most of us did not know each other even at all, let alone have a friendship. So it was interesting. It was kind of like your first day of school and you go into the cafeteria and you are you're nervous because you want these people to be your friends, but you know nothing about them. So there's a lot of like weird pressure there.
Wait, you're saying when you first met each other, you already had signed on to plant and you didn't know who you were planting with?
Correct. I mean, Meredith and I knew each other.
Okay.
The rest of the team, the families and the individuals who signed, you know, who agreed to come uproot their lives in Charlottesville, didn't know each other. And so it was, it was really interesting. I think there's a lot of, there's some fear there of who are my friends going to be? Mm-hmm. Who am I going to connect with?
Yeah.
And you're looking at these people to be your community, but you haven't had any kind of in-depth relationship with them yet. So yeah, it was interesting. It took some time, I think, for a lot of people to develop deep friendships, but the Lord provided, and it is really sweet to see the community that he laid out for us.
Well, I specifically want to talk about y'all's relationship. So you came in, your husbands are both, they're planting together. Josh is the lead pastor, that's Meredith's husband. And Bailey's husband, Justin, is the executive pastor. Was that his title at the beginning?
No. So he was the director of college when we planted, right? Yeah, he was the director of college when we planted and then became an elder. And so then he was the pastor of college and discipleship. And then became the executive pastor.
Okay.
I don't remember the time frame that all of that happened, but.
Okay. But you guys didn't know each other super well when you planted together as couples. But I would love to know, I mean, I've gotten to see y'all's relationship develop over the years that you've done this and hear about it. And you say that really your relationship with one another is a sweet spot for you. In ministry. So I'd love to, I love that term that you use, sweet spot. And I'd love to know how each of you would describe your relationship with one another. Meredith, will you go first on that?
Yeah, absolutely. It really is. Like when I say sweet spot, I think it's just like just a gift. I think it's been a gift this whole time in this journey. And we didn't know each other super well when we started. We knew kind of vaguely and had interacted a handful of times. But I feel like in the early days, we spent a good amount of time. Like we would have weekly dinners together, and really started investing in one another. And I think that has just borne fruit over a long period of time. And so really, like, I mean, church planting is hard. It has ups and downs and highs and lows. But I feel like Bailey and our relationship has been such a sweet gift through the whole time. It's just a really neat encouragement. Like it's very life-giving to spend time with Bailey. And it's just, yeah, it's very unique, but it is a huge blessing because there's this mutual encouragement. Like we are experiencing the same things as pastor's wife. Like both of our husbands are on staff and there's a uniqueness to that we get to go through and like encourage one another in and pray for one another through. Like Bailey understands what it looks like to get up on a Sunday morning and get all her kids up and dressed and fed and, you know, to church. And so I think there's like, yeah, I think just having this relationship and getting to go through the seasons of ministry together has been really sweet.
Yeah. I was just going to add, I think that one word that comes to mind when I think about our friendship is just safety. Like I just feel really safe with Meredith. I think we established that from the get-go of wanting to have a lot of trust between us. I feel like very confident that Meredith isn't going to go share with other people what I entrust to her. And I think because of our husband's role, that's like super important that we have a lot of, just trust and we really care for one another and what we're sharing. And so I think that just the safety of our friendship has been really sweet. And that if things are hard, if we're going through a hard season of ministry, I know that Meredith has my back and I have her back and we're just going to continue to pray and press on.
Well, that didn't just happen overnight. What you're describing, a lot of pastors' wives desire, but they don't have that within their own church staff. There may be women who listening who are completely on their own. Their husband's the only one on staff. But for those who have someone else on staff, they desire this type of relationship and don't always have it. And so I would love for you to speak for each other and say, like, Bailey, what has Meredith done to bring the relationship to a place where you can say, I feel safe in this relationship. I feel like I can share in this relationship. What are things that she has specifically done?
Yeah, I think in the beginning, before we even planted, she initiated with me spending time together. And that was really great because it started to develop a foundation for us to have a friendship to build on once we got to Charlottesville. So I think her initiating with me in the beginning so that we started to build a friendship because we didn't have one before. And she was very clear in giving some kind of some boundaries of like, this is my life. At that point, she had three kids that were very little. I had zero kids. And at that point, she was very clear with me, hey, this is kind of the season of life I'm in. You're going to have to come to my house. You're going to have to like hang out with me with my kids. She wasn't like as blunt as that, but it was great that she was just really honest with me about her limits and her boundaries in this season of life that she was in. And I think that was really helpful for me because as a, you know, as just a married person with no children, my limits and capacities looked so different. And I didn't have a ton of empathy for her season of life. So it was great for her to just really kindly share that with me. And I think that allowed our friendship to thrive because we had an understanding of the season of life that we were each in.
That's helpful to kind of set out some expectations, but also saying, I want relationship with you, but this is how it can work for me. Can you do that kind of thing? That's really helpful. So Meredith, what did Bailey do to help?
Yeah, I think it's really clear what Bailey did. She was very available. I feel like she brought her availability and was like, here I am, like, I'll come to your house, you know, whatever. I remember even when we first moved to Charlottesville, one day I was at home with my kids in the backyard and you like showed up with donuts or like pastries from the farmer's market. Like I couldn't go to the farmer's market with my three young kids, but Sweet Bailey got to go and brought us all treats, which is really sweet. And so I think her availability and I just think her vulnerability as well, like just from the beginning, I think Bailey has also wanted relationship and like been very real. And so I think that has really helped us foster deep, meaningful friendship as well.
That's great. I'd love to talk about that vulnerability because I have felt sometimes when I'm thinking of specifically when I go to a conference for pastor's wives or something like that, and you sit down at a table and you're like, I am the only pastor's wife probably here who is struggling. You just kind of have that feeling of, I don't have it together, but everyone else seems to have it together and know what they're doing. But ministry is so hard. Mm-hmm. And so I'm wondering how did Bailey specifically, or Bailey, you could answer it for Meredith, or for yourself, how did you take that step of vulnerability? Because at some point you kind of have to be the one to say, hey, this is harder than I thought it was going to be, or this is not going how I thought it was going to go. Somebody has to take that first step. Can you think back to something that either of you did that took the relationship to that level?
That's a great question. I think that, you know, just off the top of my head, I think that that's something that just takes a little bit of risk at the beginning. Like you have to just be willing to open yourself up. But I think over time, it establishes that trust, like as you do it and it's received. And so it's, I don't know if that makes sense, but I feel like it was a risk for Bailey to do that at the beginning. But then it was hopefully received well and reciprocated and over, you know, time it has built a foundation of trust and like she was saying, like safety as we process and share and
And I think that we, when Justin and I were like, okay, we're committing to Center Church with Meredith and Josh, I definitely felt this weight of like, okay, we're gonna be doing life with these people and kind of in the trenches. And I think Meredith felt the same way. And it's like Meredith needs to know all of my stuff and I need to know her stuff.
Yeah.
Cause we are going to be walking alongside each other, in a lot of difficulty, but also a lot of, you know, joy. So I think I think we both had the mindset of like, we need to be committed to one another and that's going to mean vulnerability to start propelling a friendship forward.
Yes. Yes. What you're describing is really creating a sense of team. And I think that's so important. That's always been so important to Kyle and me on any church staff we are serving. We want to be good teammates to the people we're serving with. And I think that ministry wives play a really big part in creating that kind of culture amongst the team. So what do you think are, as ministry wives are listening to this and they're thinking about their own staff team, what are some important things that you would say you really want to focus on this? Or this is an important component of being a team player or cultivating team.
This is something I've been thinking about a lot recently because about a year ago, we added three lay elders. And then a couple months ago, we actually added another full-time staff guy who is married. and has kids. And so as our, you know, we're expanding. And so I've been thinking about this a lot. And I think ministry revs play a huge role in that, particularly in a church context, but in any context. And I have three S's for you.
Oh, three things. The perfect pastor's wife with three.
That's right. My husband would be proud. I think Bailey touched on the first one for sure, is the safety, like that we would establish safety in how, you know, what we're sharing, what we're processing, like that trust, I think, is really important. The next S is security, like in the larger church, like we're a team. So we've got each other's backs. And I think wives play a huge role in that. My husband was actually talking about one of their staff behaviors is honor up, down, and all around. And that's like something they're trying to live out and work out on their staff. And I feel like that's huge for the wife, like that there would be an honor culture. Like if we want our culture of our church to be honoring, like that starts with the staff and the wives. And like, so I think, yeah, so safety, security, and then I think just like support. Mm. How can we care for one another? How can we be praying for one another? Who needs a meal? Like, yeah, just this like we're on the same team and this is not an easy task. But we feel that and get that and experience that in very similar ways. Mm. And so anyways, I think those, I feel like safety, security, support like helps build the team, but I think it also is personally encouraging. I've been thinking about, I wrote this down so I'm gonna forget. But in Hebrews where it says like exhort one another every day, or like let us stir up one another to love and good works, like wives have a unique opportunity to do that for one another because we can like empathize and feel the challenges in very similar ways. Like the average church member at our church like isn't gonna feel what we feel when it's a Sunday morning and our kid wakes up with a fever and we don't get to worship with everybody else. So I think they're like really crucial for team building, but also for just personal encouragement and ministry.
Yeah. Bailey, yeah, would you add? Yeah.
I just have an example that I think Meredith has done really well. She started this and it's been really sweet to me, but me and Meredith and then our other, the other staff wife, whose husband recently became full-time, Meredith, every Sunday morning when we first got into the building, was just sending a quick text to us of encouragement, of prayer, of scripture, of like, these are hard days, but these are like really fruitful days. And the work that we are doing might not be seen, but God sees, and let's honor him. And I think that has like,
it's like every Sunday, somebody else does it.
Yeah. So now like the three of us every Sunday, somebody chimes in and is like praying for you guys this morning. Mm. And that has been really, this has been like a balm to me and God's love, I think through the way that, just going back to the word support, I think that support has been playing out in our relationships as staff wives.
That's so good. I love that honor, the talk of honor. I think that's so important, especially because the way that we speak, I just think about the way I speak to my husband at home about the people he works with, or, you know, the other staff wives or whatever, is it really impacts and influences him and his relationships. And so for me to always be seeking to honor and to see the best in others and to believe that their heart, you know, is right and good and that they want to honor the Lord, it is so important. I mean, we impact them in so many ways. And so that honor is super important. I mean, that's something we decided a long time ago. Anyone we ever are serving with, we are always going to speak highly of them to other people, always. Mm-hmm. We will never be the people that they can come to and try to divide us. Yeah. We will always look for the best and speak the best, even if it's not, even looking for opportunities to speak the best, to help other people see the best and honor them. Mm-hmm. Do you see what I'm saying? So
totally. And I think that's also, I think in tandem with that, doing that with one another when we talk about our husband's job, because I think that can tend to be like a temptation of wanting to complain about how Justin's job is hard on me. But I think, you know, that's a slippery slope, but I think I feel encouraged by Meredith's leading of seeing this as like such a gift that what our husbands get to do and what we get to partner with them in. And so I feel like that piece of honoring how we speak about our husbands and the roles that God has given them is also really important.
That's so good. I'm wondering how this translates outside of your church into the community, because I've also seen and experienced that sometimes there can be a silo mentality amongst churches in a community. How do you guys seek to honor people who are your co-workers in the city of Charlottesville?
Christine, I feel like, you know, Charlottesville hasn't always been church planner friendly.
Nope.
And you and Kyle experienced that. And I feel like you guys really laid a foundation to change like the culture of churches' relationships with one another. Mm-hmm. Like my kids go to a private school and there's a lot of different churches represented in that school. And I feel like I have felt so cheered on by like any church, like, you know, and so I think that is a lot of the fruit of your and Kyle's labor to really bring unity there. So And in return, I mean, I, you know, we have my son's really good friend, his parents are helping plant a church in Charlottesville. And I was like, I just want to be a resource for you. Mm-hmm. Like, I want you, she has a lot of like, you know, practical questions about like, how do you guys do volunteers? I'm like, I don't know if I can answer that, but I can direct you to someone who can. So,
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, we wanted to do that for y'all and others because another church plant did that for us. And so, and a lot of churches were not accepting and welcoming of us and in very public ways. And so for this church to, is Portico, is the name of the church in Charlottesville. They just kind of were like, whatever we can do to help, they would give us things that they didn't use any longer. And so that was such a blessing to us. We were like, we want to be those people in the community as well who are, these are teammates. They're not at the same church, but they're teammates. So we're going to support them, right? So,
yeah.
Okay, so I would love to know, we've talked a lot about this very harmonious relationship that you have, which is great, but this is real life. Like, I know that you've had differences of opinion or you are different. Knowing both of you, you're very, very different. So how have you overcome or maybe even seen the differences as positive things? I'm just wondering about when the difficult times hit, how have you responded to that in your relationship with one another?
Mm-hmm. I think our differences are so extreme that it actually is a benefit and a blessing, because it's easier to see the way that God has designed Meredith that's different from me as like she is filling a gap in the body of Christ that I am not filling because of her personality and her talents. And it's really sweet to see how God's diversity in creation is actually bringing unity to the church. So I think one of the biggest ways, I think our personalities are pretty different. Mm-hmm. And I think that our capacities are pretty different. Mm-hmm. And I feel like anytime like comparison tries to creep in of like, Meredith is like such a kind, wise person that people are drawn to because she is so caring and loyal. And maybe those are true of me, but not to the degree that they are of her. And I just like want, truly, I think I have to remind myself, God designed her that way for a reason. And we should be cheering her on for the work that she's doing for the kingdom. And yeah, of course, I don't do that perfectly. And there are times where I am envious of certain things. But I think just constant prayer against jealousy and against division, because I think that's what Satan's trying to do in those moments.
Yeah.
Is just really important. And I think God has really blessed. I think he has answered those prayers and protected us from a lot of those things.
Mm-hmm. I think that's super true. Yeah, I think I feel like I felt this earlier on more than I do now, which was just Bailey is so fun. She's the most fun person in the best way that you will ever meet. So I think like when we moved to Charlottesville is a fun city. And so it was like, Bailey gets to go out and have all the fun and build all the relationships and have a home with my three children. So I think I felt the like temptation to compare certainly more earlier on. And ultimately those all me issues. That was all like my sin and really needing to grow into like what Bailey is saying, like how has the Lord gifted me and he's using us. And I think we've seen that in our families and like our families' investments. They're like in different groups of people, you know? Mm-hmm. And so that's been really cool to see like, gosh, like we are getting to invest and use our gifts and how God has even wired our families in very different ways to reach very different people.
Yeah.
You guys are, I'm asking you, so you have to say it openly, but is this stuff that you have talked about with each other? I mean, do you ever go to each other and say, hey, like I'm feeling a little competitive with you, or do you recommend that for a pastor's wife to go to another one and say, I really want to have a good relationship, but what I'm feeling is hindering what I, you know, my sin is hindering that. Do you ever talk about that openly with each other?
Yeah. Here we go. I think that, well, one, I think I would encourage that. I think whenever there's like something inside that's sinful, I mean, obviously using discretion and praying for wisdom in that conversation, but I feel like most of the time that envy probably needs to be confessed. And I think that it hasn't happened for us in a long time, but I do more recently, somebody else in the church, the other staff wives, who's not here, she is not represented, but I have in my relationship with her had to confess to her things that I have been envious of. And that has led to a really fruitful conversation because likewise, she is different from us as well. And her connections and her giftings are different. And so I think those conversations, I mean, for me, at least 10 out of 10 has led to a more humble, grateful posture towards the other person when that conversation can happen. And yeah, when you bring that sin to the light.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It kind of gives you an opportunity to confess, but also to cheerlead for each other to say, like, I thank you for sharing that with me, but I do see that God is using you in these specific ways. Like sometimes we need to hear that from one another because we see it more. We know ministry and we see how God is using that person probably more than they know or that other people would be able to see. And so it could also lead to some fruitful, positive conversation, I would think.
Definitely. I think that just like affirmation of calling out a gift or calling out like seeing like a sacrifice or something that they have done really well, I think is important. I think, I don't know if we've had this conversation, but Meredith is serving on she is a greeter on Sundays. Mm. And it is so encouraging to me that she has four little kids and she is up there greeting the people that are coming to Center Church. I mean, that like she might not hear that from anybody else of like, hey, I see the sacrifice that you're making, other than, you know, Josh probably sees that and says thank you. But that is like really important for me because I have a unique view to be able to see that and say, Meredith, I see the sacrifice that you're making. That is awesome. Like you are like sowing some really great things for the Lord. So I think that's really important since we have a unique perspective on how hard some of these things can be.
Yeah.
This is like related, but different road that I'm going down here. But I was just kind of chewing on this. I think that Bailey and I have not had to have a ton of confrontational conversations where we've had to be like, hey, you know, we haven't had a ton of those. Praise God, mostly. But I think also like we don't talk about church stuff. I don't know if this is going to make sense. Like, we don't really talk about our husband's jobs. Mm. We don't talk about, like, the ins and outs of things we know because our husbands are the pastors. Mm. Like, and I feel like there is a – that just, like, naturally shelters you from a lot of, like, envy, comparisons, competition. It's like, this is our relationship. Mm-hmm. And the church is, like, something we're a part of and we're doing and we're, you know – processing our life through that. But like, I don't know if that makes sense, but I think that that's been a huge part in that as well.
Definitely. Like we're not sitting down talking about like the logistics of of church or the decisions that Josh and Justin have made. Like I feel like we are talking more about our personal lives and our and how, and obviously church is going to come into that and our relationship with our husbands and their role is going to like seep into that and what we share. But I totally agree. I think that does protect us from some of those things.
I think y'all just hit on a huge key. is centering the relationship around Jesus, not the church, right? Yeah, you're seeking to love each other as a friend does. And that has nothing to do with what your husbands do. I mean, yes, you're going to understand things about each other that other people might not. But to me, that's the key. I think sometimes we, you know, and I want to ask you about this, Bailey, that we have maybe a younger pastor's wife on staff. Let's say she's the youth pastor. She's a brand new ministry. She looks at the senior pastor's wife and she really wants to have a relationship with her. But what she's thinking and envisioning is sometimes, or at least I can speak for myself when I was younger, is something centered around ministry, around church. And it ends up being the senior pastor's wife is not seen as a person. She's seen as the pastor's wife, or, you know, it's hard to build a relationship on that.
Totally.
Sure, you can ask a few questions and get mentorship in that, but it's not really going to be a deep relationship unless it's about the two people themselves.
Yep, absolutely.
So, Bailey, what would you say? Because I do hear a lot from younger pastors' wives, or their husbands on staff, and they just really want to gather with other staff wives. They want the pastor's wife, the senior pastor's wife, to do something to gather them, and she doesn't. She has a lot on her plate or whatever. What would you suggest for someone? And I'm asking you because you were, you are in that position where Meredith, her husband, is the lead pastor. What would you suggest to them that they can do to initiate or to try to reach out or reach toward that woman?
Yeah, I think a couple of things come to mind. I think one, having to just start from a place of humility in going towards the pastor's wife, the senior pastor's wife, coming from a place of humility of kind of knowing, or maybe not knowing, but assuming that the senior pastor's wife, aka Meredith in this instance, has probably a lot on her plate and is very full relationally. That doesn't mean that there's not room, but I think a humility of kind of knowing that that the senior pastor's wife is in a pretty unique spot. And so I think humility is the first thing. And I think just approaching it from a place of asking questions of, hey, I want to get to know you a little bit better. Do you have time to do that right now? Do you think that this is something that you would be able to invest in? And being really open to that looking unique of, you might have to come over and hang out with me when my kids are running around at 4 p.m. or, you know, like, we might not be able to meet every week. We might have to meet once a month. And I think just being very flexible is going to be important. I think those would be like my two biggest tips as far as initiating that relationship and being okay that it might not happen the way you want it to happen. Because there is, as we all know, there's just a lot going on. So it might not be this perfect friendship that I think a lot of young pastors' wives kind of envision. And that's okay. There might be a season for you guys to get a little bit closer down the road.
Yeah. Yeah. That's really good. Well, I think everyone listening can tell we are all passionate about this and really see the need for these types of relationships. I just look in my ministry trajectory and some of the most important relationships have been other pastors' wives, whether they're at my church or they're somewhere else. But I really think that these relationships are vital for us in order to thrive in ministry. Would you agree? I mean, I think y'all are as passionate about it as me. So I appreciate y'all joining me to share about your story. I'm excited about what God's doing at Center Church in Charlottesville, and I'm thankful for y'all. Thanks so much for listening to the Ministry Wives Podcast, a production of the North American Mission Board. If you found this content helpful, please subscribe, rate, and review us on your podcast platform or share it with a friend. You can find this podcast and other helpful resources at ministrywivespodcast.com.